Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. The number one driver of aesthetic practice are millennials or those under the age of 35. They're looking for many different things, but one is, of course, angles, projection, and symmetry. And today, I'm addressing symmetry, particularly in the cheeks. Bone structure does many things for us, keeps us young. Sometimes there's a nice anterior angle. We look at the jawline with the goniometer or the gonial angle, but also because of that bone, one of the cheeks often will project less forward and one side be narrower than the other. And in this video, I'm injecting one anterior cheek for projection and one high lateral to create a little more width, which is all important to the newcomers to our practice and the new aesthetic paradigm that we're seeing. Let's go to the video and watch the microcannula injections now. So what we're doing here, we're gonna do a microcannula technique with Restylane Lift. It's the only FDA approved filler. And I'm using a 2-inch 25 gauge cannula, and that works great with lift. I'm gonna make my opening inferior. We're creating a bit of symmetry and forward projection. So on this side, going to put a little poke here, and we can use, do you like a little vibration? We can put that.
Sure.
Great.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. So a little poke here. So we're going to make that opening and just stretch the tissue side to side. There should be no blood at all with this. And in fact, to the point where you might not even find your opening. And we're not doing a lot of work here. Obviously, she looks amazing, but we're creating angles. And this is probably the most common thing we do now. And this is the demographic that's most coming into clinics. Now, I don't want any product down low. She wants a beautiful high cheek. This is her wide side. We're not adding any here. But on this side, we noticed there was less forward projection than on her right. So I'm going through some fibrous tissue. The orbicularis oculi starts up here. I'm really in the fat pads of the mid face. And again, we don't have to do a lot of product. We're just creating, preventing, and kind of raising the side just a little bit. Restylane Lift has a high G prime. That's what we want for a product. And here, I'm just at the inferior margin of the orbicularis oculi. So if I'm there, I wanna be a little below it. I definitely don't wanna be above it. Although she has fantastic skin, we don't wanna see product. And by staying deeper, that helps prevent that. I can watch, because I'm at a lateral angle. Her high point should be from the lateral canthus inferior. She's young, you could make a case for it being laterally here. Both would look good. In this case, we're going with her natural projection. This is her maximal light reflection, and we can always adjust that over time. But that's where I like it. I mark her because it's subtle what we're doing, and when she lies back, I'm losing my landmarks. So here, I just remove them because they can distract the injector's eye. I make sure that it looks good from all angles. Remember, it's three-dimensional filling that's important. And I like the look of that. We have enough volume, and that was just 0.25. So again, we're cleansing the skin. I use a lot of hypochlorous. And what these marks mean something to me. Everyone marks a little differently. I know where I want to be. I stay a little higher in case it settles down. And this means to me that I'm going to taper a little bit, and I can go that low. I cannot go below there, and that's why I mark below where I kind of would put an implant. And that's what the lower marks mean, so I will never inject below that. And that's when I looked at her when she was sitting up. Now, vibration works well, gait theory of pain, a little poke here coming. And I'm just entering the dermis. What a lot of people do, see there's no blood, they go in and out with the needle. That's going to create a bruise. One of the reasons we use a cannula is so that we don't bruise our patients. And I'm gonna cover the hair here. It should be like this, where I can't even find my opening. You can tease it, and I can see it there. And so, now I don't wanna inject right at the opening. I'm gonna create a bump that I don't want, and it'll look like a pimple, but it isn't, it's product, and that creates a problem. I wanna go past that. And remember, the pain sensation is on the outside. So I'm gonna push, you might feel a little pressure, but it's more painful to the injector than the patient. The injector often will cringe and say, oh, I can't push, I don't wanna push hard, and the patient isn't in pain. You need to push through that. I'm always looking at her eye here. If she's in pain, that eye will wince, always. And that gives me an indication of what's going on with the patient. You do not want to be a slow injector. You don't want to be too fast. Your cadence of the needle should be perfect. If you're too slow, that means you don't know what you're doing and you don't know where you're going to be. And most importantly, you're creating pain for your patient. The patient should only need to be in your clinic for 15 minutes. And that's about a good level of pain tolerance. If you've had laser hair removal, you know by 20 minutes you're done with it. So that's all I'm doing. I love these markers because I can immediately remove it, look at my work and evaluate it and see if I like it. And I like that angle. I want to match the width of the other side. Her bone structure is wider over here. And I always look straight down the pike here. Perfect. If I'm a little high here, that's what I want because I know it's going to settle in. Always err on the side of higher, more sharply demarcated. What Restylane Lip does great, it leaves that. If she finds it too high on day 3, and I know she won't, if I did a vial or two, she can massage it on day 3 and dull it or make it less pronounced. It's nice to have that option, but I know, and knowing her, she's gonna like it. So thanks for joining me today on this channel. Go to Instagram for before and after pictures. Also subscribe here and join us weekly for continued helpful tips to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.